Let's talk about reference points. When you plunge, you can see the plunge. There's really nothing to interpret. It's just news hits straight down. But there is something, and you can see that here. I'll zoom it in. You can see how we've stopped trading. After the initial drop, we've basically frozen. And there is a reference point. The lows on Christmas Eve for the market and for Apple, in this case, 146.59. And here it is at 146.55, 146.60, meaning it has found those prior lows, and now there are people that are stepping in, other people are continuing to sell. So we've reached a reference point. But longer term, of course, that's the bigger story. So let's see if we can pull back and find some insight into a longer term chart. What we know is that Apple doesn't really have support until you get back to the highs of 2013. So from my point of view, what we would all say is there has to be this, a break in trend. Now, if I clear that and then try to put this line on the tops, that might give us some reference point as to how much more this could drop. And basically, those highs come into play around 135, which would be maybe 7 to 8% lower from where it is now. That's a perfectly reasonable price objective. I'm going to do the Qs, then I'm going to quit. Keep this in mind. Burn this on your retina. Remember those tops. Now look, and this is the bigger issue for the market, look how far the Qs are from their highs. Meaning, if I did this same exercise and drew this line, this is nowhere near. And that's the risk, meaning the spillover effect. Apple has had more of a drawdown, down almost 40% now, where we know that's not the case with the general tech market. Presumptively, this could get worse in line with Apple.
Yeah, Carter, thank you. Carter Worth, Cornerstone for us. Boy, the Qs tomorrow. Watch out.
Well, the Qs, as Carter pointed out, still on a relative basis to themselves have some room to go. Remember, we started this day talking about China, right? I mean, this day was all about China macro overnight that got their PMI, the lowest in 17 months, in contraction territory, four major economies in Asia in contraction territory. So the dynamic of global growth, and I would go back to the market, I mean, 263 in the 10-year, I mean, we're trading as if this market is slowing down fast. And remember, this was guidance on Q1, their fiscal fourth quarter, their fiscal Q1, their fourth quarter, their best season. We are waiting for companies to deliver good news for this market. That's not a good start, and this is the most important company.
But isn't it fair to say, guys, that, like, you know, when you think about just this cut, you know, we're going to have numbers cuts across the board. This is a company that's supposed to have $61 billion in net income in fiscal 2019. So when you're thinking about S&P earnings for 2019 and what that growth is going to be, this is a massive hit. We've already seen Facebook take a huge chop, right, to their 2019 estimates. You really have to extrapolate this. And I just want to make one point. I know that some of you guys have talked about maybe this has pushed Xi and Trump closer together. Global markets don't turn on a dime. They can have an announcement here, and these economies are not going to start reasserting themselves that quickly. So this is a first half 2019.
Which thing. Are the suppliers are you going to? We haven't even. I don't think
Skyworks,
we've even.
Broadcom, Skyworks, yeah.
Texan, you know, right? Doesn't
Corvo.
Texas Instruments?
Sure, Texan.
Yep. Can we throw up some of those
semi
guys, please? I mean, that's a story in and of itself as well that you're going to have to follow tomorrow. Look
right.
at these. Look at Lumentum, right?
I think that's
right?
a great question. So a lot of these companies have already guided lower. The question is, and which I don't know the answer to, will they have to guide lower again? I mean, on valuation, some of these stocks are still expensive. We actually had a conversation saying the other day talking about how Micron's probably more expensive now at lower prices than it was $10 or so ago. It's somewhat counterintuitive. So you might have to see a re-guide lower from the Corvo, Skyworks, Broadcoms,
Qualcomm.
And I wouldn't focus just on tech, though, too. I mean, to Dan's point, if this is a multi-quarter economic slowing, who has China as their largest customer? Europe. And they already have a slowing economy there. So you could see other companies. You could see industrials fall on this. You could see anybody who has exposure to both APAC, Asia Pacific, and Europe fall on this news if the market extrapolates that the China slowing is going to last for a long time.